start electrode potential, what are the factors affecting electrode potential and EMF of this cell, and how can we calculate the E0 cell, that is most important. You will put the problem, I will solve also the problem, that is very important in this year counseling exam, because you will put definitely this question, probably from this E0 cell, 2-mark question is most important. 2-mark question, factors affecting the electrode factors affecting the electrode potential. So what are the factors? It affects the electrode potential. It depends upon the nature of the metal and its ion. First factor, it depends upon the nature of the metal and its ions. It depends upon the nature of the metal and its ion. Concentration of the ions in the solution.
What is the concentration of the ions in the solution? Concentrations of the ions in the solution, thermic temperature.
It depends upon the nature of the metal and its ion, concentration of the ions in the solution, temperature.
This, basing upon these three factors, it depends upon these following three factors.
Electron potential depends upon the three factors. What are these?
First is depth. What is the nature of the metal?
Whether the metal is reactive or non-reactive, inert or not reactive, like platinum, gold, these are inert metals. Platinum and gold, these are inert metals. We use inert metal for the inflow and outflow of electron. Then provide the surface for the oxidation and reduction of the when we use gas electrode, we use platinum electrode as a supporting electrode, that is used for the inflow and outflow of electrons. Clear? So, electrode potential depends upon the nature of the metal and its ion, concentration of the ions in the solution, temperature. These three factors, electrode potential depends upon these three factors. Clear? Electrode potential always depends upon these three factors. Next, we will discuss what is EMF of the cell. What is EMF of the cell? EMF stands for electromotive force. Electromotive force. It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cells. What is EMF of the cell? EMF of the cell is defined as the algebraic difference in the electrode potential of the two half cells. So we will discuss EMF of the cell or cell potential. EMF of the cell or cell potential. What is EMF of the cell or cell potential? It is denoted in the short form, we can write E cell. EMF of the cell or cell potential, this is E cell. That is electromotive force of the cell or cell potential. What is EMF of the cell? EMF of the cell, short term, you can write E cell. That is
EMF of the cell. When you are writing E0 cell or E0 cell, that is called standard EMF. That is called the simple EMF. This is standard EMF. So next we will discuss what is standard EMF. So let us, what is EMF of this cell?
It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cells
is known as EMF of this cell.
It is
defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cells.
It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cells.
So what is EMF of the cell? It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electron potential of two half cells is known as EMF of the cell. EMF of the cell is known as EMF of the cell. It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cells is known as EMF of the cell
or cell potential.
EMF of the cell or cell potential. It is ethical experiment is known as EMF of the cell or cell potential. It is defined as the EMF of the cell or cell
potential.
Clear?
It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cells.
Ethical definition. Is known as EMF of the cell or cell potential. Ethical definition.
It is denoted as E cell.
Eta ko uttar sam denote kora jibo.
It is denoted as E cell. It is denoted as E cell.
Yeah.
So what is EMF? Simple difference between the electrode potential of two half cells. Gutella zinc half cell, a galvanic cell, whatever we have discussed. One is zinc half cell, another is copper half cell. So it is the difference between the electrode potential of two half cells is called
EMF of the cell or cell potential.
It is the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cells is called
EMF of the cell or cell potential.
Simple. Duita potential, zinc half cell one potential, copper half cell another potential. It will difference this potential will give the EMF of this cell. EMF full form is electromotive force. Full form of EMF is electromotive force. Hello.
So what is EMF of the cell or cell potential? It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cells. One will be higher potential, another will be lower potential.
So you will difference this potential in order to get the EMF value of the cell. Clear?
So it is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cell is known as EMF of the cell or cell potential. It is denoted as E cell. So this is simple EMF. Next we will discuss what is standard EMF. Same definition. Whenever this occurs at 1 molar concentration and dissolution maintaining temperature 298 Kelvin or 25 degree centigrade is called standard EMF. So simple definition. standard EMF. Next we'll discuss standard EMF of the cell, which is denoted as P0 cell. Standard EMF of the cell E0 cell. It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electron potential of two half cells when the concentration of the two half cells when the concentrations of the when the concentration of the It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electron potential of two half cells when the concentration of the two half cells are 1 molar when the concentration of the two half cells are 1 molar and maintaining the temperature at 290 Kelvin or 45 degree. See previous definition ja e definition is here. See the simple here, the standard here. E ra ko denote kore jibo it is denoted as E0 cell. It is denoted as It is denoted as inert cell or standard EMF. So what is standard EMF and what is simple EMF? Same definition. Standard is when the solutions maintaining temperature 298 Kelvin or 25 degree centigrade and concentrations of the two half cells are 1 molar. Solution 1 molar concentration thibo, temperature 298 Kelvin or 25 degree centigrade itara maintain kar debo, select kar debo standard condition. Whenever you measuring that EMF of the cell, that is called standard EMF. And at any concentration other than the and any temperature, whenever you measuring, that is simple EMF. So simple EMF and standard EMF difference is that whenever you maintaining standard conditions, you measure the EMF of the cell, that is standard EMF. Whenever you measure the EMF of the cell at any other conditions, other than 1 molar solution or concentration, 1 molar thibo nahi, kimba temperature 290 Kelvin or 25 degree centigrade thibo nahi. Whenever you measure the EMF, that is simple EMF. But when the solutions to half cell thibo 1 molar concentration, output is Kelvin or 25 degree centigrade. Setable C EMF to call by the standard EMF of the cell. That is called standard EMF of the cell or E0 cell. That is called E0 cell or E0 cell. Clear? So what is standard EMF? What is simple EMF? Is that clear? Simple EMF, it is the algebraic difference between the electron potential of two half cells. गुटे दीटा हाफ सेल अछि गुटा जिंक हाफ सेल गुटा कॉपर हाफ सेल गाइस वाटिंग सेल जिंक हाफ सेल गुटा पोटेंशियल कॉपर हाफ सेल अनदर पोटेंशियल सो यू विल सिंपल डिफरेंस दिस पोटेंशियल यू विल सिंपल डिफरेंस दिस पोटेंशियल इन ऑर्डर टू कैलकुलेट द EMF of this cell. This is simple EMF, that is E cell. We can simple generally use in E cell one formula, E cell equal to E right minus some books you will read, E cell equal to E right, E cell equal to E right minus E left. এটাই ফর্মুলা ইউজ করছেন ই সেল ইকুয়াল টু ই রাইট মাইনাস ই লেফট দেন স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ইএমএফ দি স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ইএমএফ অফ দি সেল দি স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ইএমএফ অফ দি সেল ই নট সেল ইট ইজ ডিফাইন্ড অ্যাজ দি অ্যালজেব্রিক ডিফারেন্স বিটুইন দি ইলেকট্রন পটেনশিয়াল অফ টু হাফ সেল ওয়েন দি কনসেন্ট্রেশন অফ দি ওয়েন দি কনসেন্ট্রেশন অফ দি সলিউশন অফ দি টু হাফ সেলস আর 1 মোলার এন্ড মেইনটেইনিং দি টেম্পারেচার এট ক্রাইটেরিয়া অফ 45 ডিগ্রি সেন্টিগ্রেড Maintaining temperature, maintaining the temperature of the solution, maintaining the temperature of the solution, maintaining the temperature of the solution. Solution तो लिखा ही थी, previous तो लिखा ही थी. Simple standard condition कौन? What is standard condition? Whenever you maintain the solutions. 1 molar concentration and temperature 298 Kelvin or 25 degree centigrade. That is standard condition. Or simple, it is defined in the algebraic difference between the electrical potential of 2 half cells at standard step. In the when it is defined in the algebraic difference between the electrical potential of 2 half cells. Major air standard step. This line. Up to this line, when the concentration of the solution of the two half cells are 1 molar and maintaining the temperature of the solution at 290 Kelvin. This term, otherwise. যদি E0 cell or E0 cell. E0 cell is standard EMF. So E0 cell, what you can say? Standard EMF and E cell. This is simple EMF. Inner cell is standard EMF. Inner cell is standard EMF. E cell is simple EMF. Here, E cell is simple EMF. Inner cell is standard EMF. Clear? So, what is standard EMF of the cell? Standard EMF of the cell, it is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cell, simple equation, measured at standard state, or it is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cell when the concentration of the solution of the two half cells are 1 molar and maintaining the temperature of the solution at 290 Kelvin or 25 degree centigrade. A underline this when the concentration of the solution of the two half cells are 1 molar and maintaining the temperature of the solution at 298 Kelvin or 25 degree centigrade, you write this line up to this. If you cannot write this, then you write up to this and or if you will not write the or. You will write it is defined in the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cell measured at standard state. It is defined as the algebraic difference between the electrode potential of two half cell measured at standard state. This is called standard EMF. This is called standard EMF of the cell. Clear? This is called standard EMF of the cell. Clear? Then I will give you the formula. Whenever you will use this formula, definitely you will have to calculate the inner cell. You will never be wrong.
I will give you the tricks, the important tricks which I will give you, then you can calculate the inner cell, any type of inner cell easily. Look at it. The potentials are given, whether it is oxidation potential, how you can know that this is oxidation potential and this is reduction potential. How it is oxidation potential and how it is reduction potential, you can easily calculate. Here, in order to calculate the scattered EMF, I am using this formula. This formula is very important. So always you try to use this formula. Okay. Another I am giving the tricks that, as you know that if you know the reduction potential of one electron, then you can calculate the oxidation potential of another same electron. And if you know the oxidation potential, you can calculate the reduction potential easily. How they know that? Okay. E0 zinc 2 plus by zinc. Look at zinc 2 plus changes to zinc. Whether this is oxidized or reduced, it is first you have to know. Zinc 2 plus converted to zinc, that is reduction potential. That is because zinc 2 plus changes to zinc. How can zinc 2 plus changes to zinc? Zinc 2 plus 2 electron. That gives rise to zinc, that is minus 0.76 volt. So this is reduction potential. So same thing, look at E0 zinc. That is plus 0.76. Look at zinc 2 plus reduced to zinc 2 plus reduced to zinc minus 0.76 volt. Zinc is oxidized to zinc 2 plus 0.76 volt. Yeah, so this is oxidation potential, this is reduction potential. This is reduction potential, this is oxidation potential. Is that clear? Is that clear or not? So this is oxidation potential, this is reduction potential. So zinc 2 is, whether this is given, E0 is given, first the key of zinc 2 plus will change, whether that is reduction energy or whether that is oxidation. If oxidation occurs, that is oxidation potential. If reduction occurs, that is reduction potential. Clear? If oxidation occurs, oxidation potential. If reduction occurs, then reduction potential. Clear? So, in order to calculate the E0 cell, I am giving you the very important formula. I will give you a very important formula. Look at, you must use this formula in order to calculate the inner cell or E0 cell, or that is standard EMF. You use this formula. That formula is very important to calculate the inner cell. Clear? Inner cell equal to reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode. E0 cell, reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of
anode. Oxidation potential of anode minus oxidation potential of
you use first formula or second formula. So in order to use this formula or this formula, whether you will observe the potentials are given in reduction term or in oxidation term, that is very important. You have to choose whether the potentials are given in oxidation term or whether the potentials are given in reduction term. That is very important. So first I am solving one two problems. How look at, so you may use this potential. Actually when the reduction potential are given in reduction term, you use this formula. When the potentials are given in oxidation term, it is this formula. Kya use kare first formula, when the potentials, when the potentials are given in, when the potentials are given in, when the potentials are given in reduction term, and when you use this formula, when the potentials are given in oxidation, when the potentials are given in oxidation term, you use this formula. When the potentials are given in reduction term, you use this formula. Clear? सिंपल मन रख, जते बेले पोटेंशियल का रिडक्शन टर्म न दिबो ए फार्मूला यूज करबो, जते बेले पोटेंशियल का ऑक्सीडेशन टर्म न दिबो तते बेले ए फार्मूला यूज करबो. क्लियर? व्हेन द पोटेंशियल्स आर गिवन इन रिडक्शन यू यूज दिस फार्मूला, व्हेन द पोटेंशियल आर गिवन इन ऑक्सीडेशन टर्म यू यूज दिस फार्मूला. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दिस इज इट. नेक्स्ट आई एम सॉल्विंग प्रॉब्लम्स. Calculate the ejection or standard, calculate the ejection or standard EMF of the following cell, following redox reaction, following a cell reaction, following cell reaction. Calculate the EGR cell or standard EMF of the following cell reaction. Zinc solid copper 2 plus aqueous, zinc 2 plus plus copper. Given that E0 G2 plus by G minus 0.76 volts, E0 क्वेश्चन देख फास्ट यू विल चेक व्हिच इज ऑक्सीडाइज्ड व्हिच इज रिड्यूस्ड
लुक एट जिंक इज ऑक्सीडाइज्ड टू जिंक 2 प्लस कॉपर 2 प्लस इज रिड्यूस्ड टू कॉपर सल्फेट जिंक इज ऑक्सीडाइज्ड टू जिंक 2 प्लस कॉपर 2 प्लस इज रिड्यूस्ड टू कॉपर सल्फेट
क्लियर सो यू लुक दिस अदरवाइज इफ यू कैनॉट लुक दिस यू लुक दिस द ए जो पोटेंशियल इफ द two potentials are given whether that is in reduction term or whether that is in oxidation term that is very important this potential is in reduction this potential is in reduction so the two potentials are given in reduction
jete bale dui ta potential reduction nahi thibo you use the formula e zero sale ko reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode jete bale dui ta potential oxidation nahi thibo you use the formula oxidation potential of anode minus oxidation potential of cathode That is very important.
So, यदि दो इटा potential को चल देंगे, this is also reduction, this is reduction potential, this is also reduction potential. So, two potentials are given in reduction. G two plus converted to G, copper two plus converted to copper. This is reduction, this is reduction. So, when the two potentials are given in reduction, you have to use the formula reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode. When the potentials are given in oxidation you use the formula oxidation potential of anode minus oxidation potential of cathode yeah so doita potential record dei the two potentials are given in reduction term Since the two potentials are given in reduction term, you have to use the formula E zero is equal to reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode. Look at
we know that E zero is equal to reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode
so what which is cathode simple tricks if the two potentials are given in reduction term jati dui ta potential reduction term re achi tale higher value ta cathode lower value ta anode jati dui ta potential oxidation re achi higher value ta anode lower value ta cathode eta lekhi niyo if the two potentials are given in reduction term If the two potentials are given in reduction term, then higher value is cathode, lower value is anode. If the two potentials are given in oxidation term, if the two potentials are given in oxidation term, then higher value is anode, lower value is cathode. That is the trick. Clear?
जोधी दूसरा potential reduction हो ची, higher value cathode, lower value anode. जोधी दूसरा potential ऑक्सीडेशन अच्छी हायर वैल्यू एनोड लोअर वैल्यू कैथोड सिंपल इफ द टू पोटेंशियल्स आर इन रिडक्शन टर्म देन हायर वैल्यू इज कैथोड लोअर वैल्यू इज एनोड इफ द टू पोटेंशियल्स आर इन ऑक्सीडेशन टर्म हायर वैल्यू इज एनोड लोअर वैल्यू इज कैथोड क्लियर
सो इज द सेल कैथोड टू पोटेंशियल्स आर इन रिडक्शन सो हायर वैल्यू दिस वैल्यू इज 0.34 माइनस और माइनस 0.76 यह सो दिस विल बी 1.10 लुक एट दिस इज द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 सो हियर पुट टू मार्क क्वेश्चन कैलकुलेट द इंजरेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड ईएमएफ ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सेल रिएक्शन दिस इज द रिएक्शन This is reduction potential. This is reduction potential. We know that each reaction equal to reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode. This will be this. Simple. Same question. Next, write down. Same question. He will give this. look at this reaction. This is oxidation. Look at this is oxidation. If this pattern of question is given, with if the two potentials are given in oxidation, then you use this formula: oxidation potential of anion, oxidation potential of cation. Which is, jyoti duita potential oxidation achi. If the two potentials are in oxidation, higher value is anion, lower value is cation. Higher value is anion. So this will be 0.76 minus of minus 0.34. So this will be 1.10. Clear? Look at. If the two potentials are given in oxidation, then higher value is anode, lower value is cathode. If the two potentials are given in reduction, higher value is cathode, lower value is anode. Clear? This is the very important thing. Jodi duita potential reduction achi, tala higher value. जदि दुईटा पोटेंशियल रिडक्शन अछि हायर वैल्यू कैथोड लोअर वैल्यू एनोड जदि दुईटा पोटेंशियल ऑक्सीडेशन अछि हायर वैल्यू एनोड लोअर वैल्यू कैथोड दिस इज द ट्रिक्स क्लियर इफ द टू पोटेंशियल्स आर गिवन इन रिडक्शन देन हायर वैल्यू इज कैथोड लोअर वैल्यू इज एनोड इफ द टू पोटेंशियल्स आर गिवन इन ऑक्सीडेशन देन हायर वैल्यू इज एनोड लोअर वैल्यू इज कैथोड क्लियर सो दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 This is question number 2. Clear? Next two questions I will solve. पोटेंशियल का देखिए ऑक्सीडेशन कॉल टू प्लस रहती 0.28 सो लुक एट कैलकुलेट द इजरो सेल ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सेल कैलकुलेट द इजरो सेल ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड ईएमएफ ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सेल रिएक्शन सो लुक एट जिंक इज ऑक्सीडाइज्ड
cobalt 2 plus is reduced. But the potentials are given. Look at this is also oxidation potential, this is also oxidation potential. So where the two potentials are given in oxidations, we have to use the formula where this is also oxidation, zinc is oxidized to zinc 2 plus, cobalt is oxidized to cobalt 2 plus. So where the two potentials are given in oxidation, we have to solve this problem in another way. This is the formula, which formula you use? Second. We know that each Russell equal to oxidation potential of anode minus oxidation potential. Oxidation potential of anode minus oxidation potential of cathode. Yeah. So which will be anode? If the two potentials are in oxidation, higher value will be the anode, lower value will be the cathode. So this will be 0.76 minus 0.28.
Kya
tha sir? 16 bar bola.
A
ye bola.
Look at if the two potentials are given in redox, it this is oxidation. Jodi duita potential oxidation achieve higher value ta ala kon anode, eta ala anode, eta ala cathode. So oxidation potential of anode, anode is equal to 0.76, cathode is kuda 0.28. clear? Jodi duita potential, ei duita potential oxidation re achi higher value ta hala anode, lower value ta hala cathode. So this is anode, this is cathode. So anode 0.76, 0.76, cathode is kete 0.28. So 0.481. Clear? So if the two potentials are given in oxidation, then higher value is anode, lower value is cathode.
Clear?
If the two potentials are given in oxidation, then higher value is anode, lower value is if the two potentials are given in oxidation, high value is anode, lower value is cathode. Clear? It is anode, it is cathode. Because it is higher value. So if the two potentials are given in reduction, then high value will be. It is the third equation.
Same question. It is equation.
Dekha. Question number 3 kar diya dekho. Ek question na equation tha. Question number 3.
Same question. It is equal to the minus look at this is reduction. This is also reduction. So when the two potentials are in reduction, what you have to put a higher? This is higher, this is lower. Either these are reduction delay, higher on the cathode, it has zero cathode.
It has zero cathode, it has zero.
So this is reduction.
So reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of
anode.
Reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode minus 0.28 minus of minus 0.76.
This is question number 3. So, somewhere you will check
Every time you will check whether the potential is given in oxidation or reduction. If the two potentials is given in oxidation, whether the two potentials are given in oxidation or whether the two potentials are given in reduction. If the two potentials are given in oxidation, you have to use the formula E is equal to oxidation potential of anode minus oxidation potential of cathode. If the two potentials are given in reduction, then you have to use the formula reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode. Clear?
Next
two questions, I am giving you the home task. You will solve this question. Otherwise, next class I will solve this. Yeah.
Calculate the standard EMF. Calculate the standard EMF of the following cell reaction: cadmium 2+ plus Fe solid, cadmium solid Fe2+ aqueous. Given that E0 এটা কার্ডিয়ামটা দিচ্ছি কার্ডিয়াম E0 কার্ডিয়াম কি বলো -0.5 calculate the standard EMF of the following cell reaction. This another question. So you will try to, this is homework, you have to solve these two problems in your form. Next class, if you cannot solve this, I will solve this. These are the very important question. Maybe you put this question. Clear? With this, this class is over. Thank you.